Welcome back from the break. We are still here with Joel Oriem, a physiotherapist from the Aga Khan University Hospital. We are talking about physiotherapy and how best it can be used to restore your health. Joel, welcome back. We go back into our conversation. We are talking about the challenges that we face when it comes to physiotherapy. Are there anything like that in this field of medicine, and how best to address challenges in the world of physiotherapy?
That's perfect. That's a very good question. Now, we really appreciate the opportunity that we have for this establishment. Like I said, coupled with ignorance, and because in Uganda particularly, if you ask somebody what is physiotherapy, they will probably point to a massage parlor somewhere, because they don't know anything to do with it. So there is the issue of ignorance that we're still fixing. Mm-hmm. And then there is the issue of, like I said, the monetary version of it. Now, what we did as Aga Khan, the opportunity that we've brought is, because physiotherapy is technological dependent a lot, much as there's the manual part, but it's a mixture of technology. And so setting up a state-of-the-art department like this gives us the opportunity to bring excellence, world-class excellent service, close to the ordinary Ugandan. And the presence is all over East Africa, yeah, for now, Nairobi and here in Uganda. And so with this investment, we can actually represent or showcase the ideal practice of physiotherapy, and at a very affordable price, because the purpose is to bring excellence to our people and make it affordable. Now, when you go to other countries, these are now things that are part of their life. They have mastered it, they have lobbied for it, the governments have embraced it. We are still proving a point to bridge that gap. And so I want to tell you that when you come to the Aga Khan, our departments here, we are practicing the ideal way to do things, and guaranteed, when you come here, you get excellence to its best.
Joel, what sets the Aga Khan University Hospital apart when it comes to physiotherapy compared to the rest of the hospitals? Why should anyone choose to come to your hospital?
Now, we have state-of-the-art equipments, electrotherapy equipments, that help with pain management and facilitating tissue repair. When your tissues are injured, we have our ways of the machines that we use, and also the manual techniques that we use to help your tissues get healed. And so we have electrotherapy machines that we use. For example, I hope you've ever seen, I know you've ever seen somebody whose one face has fallen down, okay? Like, you know, there is no alignment in the mouth. You've ever seen someone like that?
Yes.
Yeah, so that is called facial palsy. It's an injury. Cranial nerve number 7, that's the facial nerve.
Make it simple.
Yes, so now when that nerve is injured, yes, we have to restore it.
Yes.
Now, you can't do it manually so much. Of course, there's the manual technique that we've been using before, but now, because of the coming of electrotherapy, we can stimulate those nerves at that time. But now with the coming of technology, we can actually locate that the nerve root and stimulate that nerve, and it recovers faster, 4 times faster. And somebody is able to get the results and their face comes back. So I've had cases. And you know, ladies, usually I had mostly ladies, and you know, it destroys their beauty and everything. So it's so good when they get back, and they get back their smile after a while. So we have these electrotherapy machines here. We have infrared. All these are just for helping with facilitating tissue repair. Then we have a host of exercise equipments for different conditions, shoulder, knee rehabilitation. We have these rehabilitation treadmills for conditioning the heart. We have the tilt beds. The tilt beds actually help to condition the heart after maybe a long time of being on bed for a while. And also to stimulate the brain regeneration after strokes. a patient can't stand, can't roll, can't stand, but then we need that. So we have all these equipments that help with weight bearing, that help with facilitating tissue repair, that help with helping us to get this person back to function and back to mobility. Yeah, so we use quite a number of things. For example, we have the traction bed, you know, for gapping back bones and neck bones. You know, many times people will come with compression syndromes, what we call prolapsed discs. And so all this is available to us with a host of other equipments that we have. And we use all this to help patients get back on their feet. We have a multidisciplinary approach that we do here, okay? And the first thing that we do is to take you through some thorough examinations from different specialists. So probably if it is orthopedic, the first place would be to see an orthopedic surgeon. We will do radiological images. We will do what we call investigations to find out how best we can help with that. Because we can fix it. It may be of different costs, but we can fix it with all this multidisciplinary approach that we have. So the orthopedic surgeon will write his report. If he needs a neuro, he will do the same. The radiological department will do the imaging. We will find out where the problem is. If it is a stiffness thing, probably we'll go with first surgery then, okay, to break up the adhesions. And if they see that there is no need for surgery, me, I am the expert as physiotherapist, we are the experts at non-conservative management. Non-conservative management. So, I mean, at conservative management. Non-conservative management is for surgeons, okay? That is surgical, non-surgical. So they will tell you, go to the physiotherapist, he can fix this. And then you come. Either way, before, whether there is need for surgery or after surgery, you will need physiotherapy again. So sometimes we can even redo whatever has gone wrong, we undo it, and then put your leg together, back together, fix the knee, and then we rehabilitate you back to function. What is the function of your leg? Is for you to be able to walk, as the first one, and possibly run, all right? So we will be able to do all that. Squatting, running, kneeling, all these are functions that, as a physiotherapist, I make sure I fix that. So it's doable.
Okay, and when you responded to the question, you said everything depends on the condition.
Yes,
perhaps
please.
For the understanding of, you know, those who are watching, we would like to know the conditions that mostly require. Like, you list them nicely so that people can get to know what are these conditions, and perhaps when they get to know, when they are going to a doctor, they might also think of aphasia. Because you say most times a surgeon will refer you.
Definitely.
But we also mentioned earlier that that is something that doesn't come so quick to maybe many medics in the hospital. You might have an issue and they don't even tell you that you need physiotherapy.
Yes.
So the conditions, which are these conditions that commonly need physiotherapy?
That's perfect. That's a good question, because now physiotherapy works in combination with other services, but it can also work as a standalone. So you can actually consult a physio, all right, directly. However, back to your question of the conditions, they are diverse.
Oh, I could come directly.
Yes, you can. Yes, you can. You can consult a physiotherapist. And like I said, it's a multidisciplinary approach. So when I find it is a surgical case, I'll refer you to a surgeon. If I find that it's something that can be fixed by a general surgeon, will definitely send you to a general surgeon before bouncing you back. So we have all this working out. It's a system, a referral system within. So there's referral up and down going on. So yes, you can consult a physiotherapist directly. However, conditions will now, is diverse, like I mentioned, many departments. Now I'm going to give you examples. So we have orthopedic conditions. Orthopedic means anything to do with your bones and muscles, all right? Majorly bones, yeah? So bone, muscles, nerves. Anything that has to do with your bones, muscles, and nerves that limits your function, whether it's a fracture that has, you know, that is healing, whether it is post-surgical, okay, maybe you've gone through surgery, and maybe like C-section, which is the commonest, okay. So orthopedic cases, degenerative cases. Degenerative means wear and tear with aging. So you find you have, you've been an asikari, you've been standing for ages, and then the knees are now having trouble, they are giving way. You come, and physio can fix that, can help to improve on the quality of the function of your knee. So yes, things that are related to your nature of work over the years, and so we're talking about occupational health, occupational hazards, all those conditions. You talk about women health, I talked about that. So for women, we are helpful to prepare you before birth, during birth, and after birth. And this one, let me mention something about this, because most women don't go for postnatal rehab to restore their muscles back, to restore the function of their pelvic floor back. And because of that, they have prolonged pain after a while. So now, maybe that is attributed to ignorance of not knowing what to do. So yes, women's health is very important for us. And then we talk about children. So we're talking about cerebral palsy, brain injuries that are there. And you have a child who is delayed. They are supposed to be walking, but they are still crawling, or they are not crawling at all. They can't sit. We help with that. We help that child to beat the milestones, and to help them, to assist them. So we have quite a number of things that we do. So neurological conditions, those are things that are related to the brain, spinal cord, and nerves. Now we are talking about stroke, head injuries. You had an accident and knocked your head, and then you lost, you know, function of. You've ever seen people with stroke? One side is paralyzed. We are the ones that help with that, together with a team of neuros. And at some point, we are the ones that are, that's why I told you there is a tilt bed, because now, like, a stroke person may not be able to. There's a stage where they can't walk, they can't even turn on bed. And that is where we start from there up to the time when they can actually walk again. So there's that's the neuro cases. Sports, sprains, strains, all these conditions that come with sports vitality. You can't avoid it. And we have a sports program here, really. Whether it's for rugby people, whether it's for basketball. I actually have a team of rugby guys, you know, legends. Then they come here for that. Now, the athletes of Uganda. Well, preparing them for you know, conditioning them for a game. Yeah, so we also have that. Apart from fixing what has gone wrong, we prepare you to prevent injury. So we give advice and specific training to condition them so that they don't injure themselves during the game, and maybe after the game. So there is a lot of patient education. If you notice, we do a lot of education. We are not mean with information. We give out the information, we educate you to how to handle this, how to prevent this, because that's part of our work. Now, when we go for office work, office, you know, talk about now occupational health, physio is part of that. We can go and actually design for you how you can arrange your office in a way that cannot hurt you over time. Functional office space. And we will help you with that and say, now, this is the height of your chair, this is the height of your table, that should be like this, okay? So there's that one as well. So it's diverse. Did I mention about heart conditions?
Much earlier.
Yes, so yes, whether it's heart surgery, whether it's after heart attack or whatever, anything to do with the circulatory system, we are very helpful to get you back, to recondition the heart again, using our different structured exercises and interventions that we use, and technology of monitoring all the vitals while we are doing all this. We do it quite professionally. Those are the major, which I can get off head at the moment, for us to appreciate the importance of this much needed department in the health department. Now, the duration of treatment will depend on, it is per patient. Everybody is different. You could have the same condition, but everyone recovers differently, depending on their response. But on average, it's from weeks. Some are for months. Some are even for life, because it is not after fixing, but after giving quality of life. So yes, it's a long-term thing, but some 3 days, I have treated people for 3 days. Somebody says, I have a neck pain, I did what and all that. They come, I fix it in 2 days. Sometimes one session is enough. So it depends on the condition, depends on the patient. And what I can tell you, the advantage we have at as us here, as the physiotherapy department on Metroplex here, we are, because of the experiences, the evidence-based, the research, and all the ongoing trainings that we go through, we've managed to reduce on those times. I think I can confidently say I do the shortest time for any conditions. Yeah, those conditions that need like 10 sessions, I will do it at 5. Not because of anything, but because we put in a lot and make sure that we get you well. So our approach is patient-centered. All right, patient-centered. So yes, the conditions will vary with the time. Fractures, for example, fractures heal in 6 weeks for adults. All right? But there are people, if you are a smoker, you are this, it will not be 6 weeks. Okay, on paper it's 6 weeks. But when you're a smoker, you drink alcohol, your bones will refuse to heal because of the intoxication. So that one now, we shall add you more weeks. Why? Until you do that. So yes, conditions will also be dependent on the patient.